they can't make friends. Pray for better days, now it's 300K when my day ends. Do you remember last night? Cause I blacked out in an all white dress with a back out. Said be careful with a heart cause it's fragile. And thinking about a past make a lash out. See what me, it ain't no worries at all. Any problem, I be there in one call. If we locked in, you my dog. Fanny, you hang pictures on my wall. Roll one, let's get high tonight. Backseat made back, lavish life. Chilling with the stars like a satellite. AP on my arm and it's shining bright.
All right, it is the start of 2022. My name's John O'Connor. Today I am going to talk to you about my best experiences of 2021. Before I do, I am going to reveal the answer of why I had the Now 20 and Now 22 covers next to each other.
So here are the covers of Now 20 and Now 22. They're right next to each other here. And here is the question why I have those covers next to each other. And the answers are A, because they are both my top two favorite Nows of all time. B, because I wanted to make a playlist with a mix of songs from Nows 20 and Now 22. C, because I wish the Now series were actually on 2022 volumes. And D, because it is New Year's 2022. So, the Saturday Morning Kid 2, Sonny's BBQ fans, Misty Firefox, Taylor Wright, Christian Roberts, and Christian Spade, you all guessed the answer to be D. So here are the answers again. And I am going to reveal the correct answer in 3, 2, 1. Ta-da! The correct answer to why I had the Now 20 and Now 22 covers next to each other, the correct answer is D. The answer is because it is New Year's 2022. See? 2022. That's why I have these two covers next to each other, because we're in the year 2022. So all you guys listed here, you all got the answer right. Anyone else? If you got the answer right, you win. If you get it wrong, you lose, but don't worry. That's okay. But the correct answer to why you had the Now 20 and Now 22 covers next to each other, the correct answer is D, because it is New Year's 2022. So a lot of you have done good with this quiz. So, but don't worry if you got the answer wrong. But yeah, the answer is D, and not A, B, or C, it's D. The correct answer, that is. All right.
So now I am going to talk to you about my best memories in 2021. So 2021 was a pretty good year. I had some good times. Today I'm deciding to share with you some of the best times I had during 2021. Well, before I do, I might want to tell you about the Nows in 2021, in my opinion. Most Nows in 2021 were pretty decent Nows, but Volume 77 and 80 had some kind of disappointing track lists. Although Volume 77 had a kind of interesting sequencing, and a lot of the songs on there had some interesting features and backgrounds. Still, though, the tracklist did look a little disappointing. So did Now 80's tracklist. Although that one did have some good songs that made it. Now 78, however, was a great CD, and I would kind of say that Now 78 was my favorite Now of 2021, especially with some miscuts from Now 77 that made Now 78, and it was really cool to see 23 tracks on there. Something that I had long waited to see for years. Now 79 was okay, but not one of the best CDs. But it was not a bad track list, though the first two tracks on there were really good songs, even though one of them is only under 2.25 minutes long. But Yeah, those are my opinions on the NAS in 2021. Alright, so that's my opinion on the NAS of 2021, but now I am going to talk about my favorite experiences of 2021 that are not NAS related. Well, first things first. Well, January, February, March, and April, not too many exciting things happened during those 4 months, but I did make a 1,000 video special in March to celebrate that milestone, which was great and good video. But other than that, nothing too exciting in January, February, March, or April in my life, in my 2021 life. But in May of 2021, I went down to Roanoke, Virginia, and I rode some famous parking garage elevators. And when I say famous, I'm talking about popular to the elevator enthusiast community, like well-known mostly to a community of elevator enthusiasts on YouTube, and not necessarily the whole world. I rode elevators in the Market Garage, the Center Square Garage, the Elmwood Garage, and the Church Garage, and a Sky Bridge, and some other garage, which I don't know the name. But I also went up to the top of Mill Mountain, and I went to see Andrew Reams, aka Diesel Ducey, the most well-known YouTube elevator filmer, in his elevator museum. I saw his elevator museum in, well, it was a good time seeing that elevator museum. I did my Roanoke adventure just like Andrew Reams did in his 2000th video special, which is one of my favorite videos I've ever watched. One other thing, I was staying in the Hampton Inn Hotel, which was right above the Market Garage. I wish I filmed a tour of it, because that hotel does look kind of interesting. And that was a good Roanoke trip, even though it was only 3 nights. That's good. But now in July, I went to Point Pleasant, and it was the 5th time I stayed there, and I actually was not too crazy about staying there for 2 weeks, because I felt like Point Pleasant went on too much for me, and the house looked a bit old and dingy, but at least I did make the best of some things, like checking out a new boardwalk and go into the Ocean Place Mall. I don't know what that new boardwalk I checked out, I don't know what that one's called. But another boardwalk I saw was Seaside Heights, though I have seen that before in previous years. But yeah, those are boardwalks. I also saw the Ocean Place Mall, which was a pretty good mall. I did do some activities as well in Point Pleasant, like arcade games, mini golf, and I went into a fun house, and that was my Point Pleasant vacation. Also, in September, I went to a Maroon 5 concert, and I enjoyed hearing their songs like What Lovers Do, Maps, Makes Me Wonder, One More Night, and Animals, and I really liked the encore too, like a 3-song encore. It was a great concert. Another thing that I enjoyed doing in September, I went to a space adventure thing. Well, not a real space adventure, but a make-pretend space adventure thing in the Palisades Center Mall in West Nyack, New York. I was a bit nervous to go in at first, but I did it anyway, and it was great. It was like almost pretending you're in outer space and you're getting lost in a rocket ship and have to find a way to return it to Earth. And it was a good game I played with my parents and stuff. That was a good activity in Palisades Center. And later in September, I also checked out the American Dream Mall, which is the second biggest mall in the U.S. and the biggest mall I have ever been to in my whole life. I like seeing the It's Sugar Place in the Nickelodeon Universe theme park. I really enjoyed walking around that mall. It was really epic. Now in October, in October 2021, I went to a Blaze Pumpkin Show, a Halloween night show, a Blaze Pumpkin Show, and I walked around the show and took a look at those pumpkin and those cool lights and stuff. It was kind of like walking around a museum, an outdoor Halloween museum. But yeah, it was really cool to see those pumpkins and those Halloween decorations and all those structures made up of pumpkins, which was really cool. And It was a good walk around this that Blaze pumpkin show in October. That was cool. Now November, I enjoyed going to Boston, Massachusetts, and I spent a night in the Omni Parker House Hotel, and I didn't like that hotel too much, and I wanted to stay in the Marriott in Boston Copley, and I was almost unable to stay in that hotel, but then my parents decided to take me there and spend another night in that hotel, and I enjoyed Boston more. It was my 7th stay in Boston and my 5th stay in the Marriott in Boston. I filmed a hotel tour of that hotel, which came out really cool, and the best part of the hotel is that it connects two shopping malls on the second floor, the Copley Place Mall and the Prudential Center Mall. That's the best part of the hotel. I really like that. I'm crazy about that part. And it makes it even more fun. I wish that was more common with other high-rise hotels. That'd be really cool. But that was a good stay in Boston, even though it was just two nights there. But one more thing. In December, I went to another Marriott hotel, but this one was a Marriott Marquis in New York Times Square, and I filmed a tour of that hotel as well. And I really like how it came out. I find it very interesting that the lobby is on the 8th floor, even though people can be confused about looking for the lobby, because usually the lobby's on the first floor of the hotel instead of the 8th floor. And sadly, the Rotating View restaurant on the 48th floor was closed for a renovation, so I couldn't go up there, but I still enjoyed staying at the hotel. I also had some fun on the high-rise glass elevators, although I did not go past floor 45, which is the highest floor with guest suites, but still, 45 stories is great. I did enjoy hanging out in Times Square as well. So those were some of my good memories of 2021. Now for 2022. What I am planning for 2022 is to go to Atlanta, Georgia in either February or March and to ride some famous glass elevators in the Hilton, Hyatt Regency, and Marriott Marquis, and maybe even the Westin Peachtree Plaza 2. Another thing I would like to do in summer 2022 is to go to Atlantic City and visit its boardwalk, which is probably the biggest boardwalk in the world. Those are some things I'd like to do this year. Well, I hope you enjoyed hearing my story of 2021 and my plans for 2022. You know, Atlantic City is in New Jersey. That's the one I'm talking about. Again, I hope you enjoyed hearing my story of 2021 and my plans for 2022. And I hope you enjoyed watching my first YouTube video of 2022 as well. Well, have a happy new year, 2022. Let's hope to have a good year. Thanks for watching. Bye.